Championship roper Freddy Vest loves the thrill of the chase and the challenge of competing against his fellow cowboys. On July 28, 2008, Freddy was headed to a calf roping in Graham, Texas. His daughter Lee remembers seeing her father off at the door.
We just hugged for a long time, and I remember turning back to tell him I love him, and it kind of brought tears to my eyes.
By 1 o'clock that afternoon, Freddy had made 3 successful calf roping runs. He was waiting to make his 4th when he suddenly dropped dead in the saddle. His friend, Dennis McKinley, recalls that day.
I was just sitting on the fence, and all of a sudden I saw this movement, all this movement out of my left eye, and then just almost simultaneously this smack. And I looked, and he was on the ground. I jumped off the fence, and I was the first one to him. And I put my hand under his head and lifted it up, and I started praying for him.
Veteran firefighter Eddie Smith was next to respond. While Eddie began CPR, Dennis called upon everyone present to pray.
While I was doing the CPR, I was praying, but I could hear people praying all around me. The Bible says the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Well, I'm going to tell you, there was a lot of men, a lot of women that were praying.
Eddie and fellow firefighter Don Lavender continued doing CPR on Freddie for 45 minutes until the ambulance arrived.
They got him on a stretcher and they put him in the ambulance. And we're looking through the windows, and they shocked him. And Eddie says to me, it doesn't look good.
He was straight lining it. That means you're dead. We just put him in God's hands.
Ambulance paramedics continued CPR and defibrillated Freddie's heart twice while en route to Graham Hospital. Doctors there were able to get an irregular heartbeat, and Freddie was immediately airlifted to Harris Methodist Hospital in Fort Worth. His heart had to be restarted twice more during the flight. Freddie's wife and son were in Mississippi visiting family when they first heard the news.
A friend called and said there was an accident at the roping. She didn't know all the details, but it's not good for, you know, told me that Freddie fell off his horse and that I, you know, needed to get to the hospital. They were going to be care flighting him. So I was just trying to get there as fast as I could. You know, you feel helpless. I felt like there's nothing I can do. It was just taking forever.
Freddie's loved ones held vigil as he was rushed into surgery. Doctors told the family that they were able to repair his heart, but weren't sure what to expect long term. Dr. Denzel D'Souza spoke with them about Freddie's chances for survival.
All cardiac arrests, and there's about 250,000 to 300,000 a year in the United States, of those only about 9% will survive. And every minute that passes without defibrillation, a restoration of blood flow, your mortality goes up 10%. The brain, you've got maybe 5, 6, 7, if you're lucky, 10 minutes to get things going again. I actually was concerned that he was going to have brain damage.
All they could do was wait.
I would go wherever I could to get along, and that's why I would pray.
While his relatives and friends were praying at the hospital, Freddie says he was somewhere else.
There's a Bible verse that says, absent from the body is present with the Lord. And when I fell off that horse, I was dead before I hit the ground. I was with the Lord, and he didn't allow me to see what heaven was like, but he let me experience what it felt like to be in heaven. He showed me the love that's there, and there's more love than you can imagine. I mean, the feeling of how much love it is incredible, and the peace that you have, it's a perfect peace. The only thing I can relate it to is when I was young, I'd crawl up my mother's lap, and she would cradle me and hold me and rock me. And that was the most peaceful, safe, loving place. And that feeling, you could multiply it times 1,000, and you still wouldn't be close to what it really feels like when you're there with the Lord. I tell some of my buddies, there's no I gotta do's in heaven. You know, there was not a feeling of time. There was no time to worry about, like, I need to go do this, I should be doing this. There's nothing like that. And
Freddie also remembers having conversations with God.
You know, but when I was there, there was communication, but it wasn't communication like words. The communication was inside of me. And it was nothing that verbally or you would have ears to hear or a mouth to speak it. It was when God tells you something, you know it's Him. He allowed me to see the prayers that came up for me. And it started with one bolt of light. And then there was two bolts of light, and three, and then there was 10, and there was like hundreds, then there was thousands of bolts of light. Each one of those bolts of light was a prayer that someone had sent up for me. And when there got to be so many bolts of light, it exploded into the brightest light. And I don't know how to explain it. It was just a very, very bright light. And that's when God sent me back. And when I came back from that, I was in the hospital bed, and they had my arms tied down. I was on life support. They had a tube down my throat, had an IV in my hand and one in my neck. And when I came to, I tried to struggle and get up. And the nurse there said, "Mr. Vest, you're okay." And I just looked at her and I said, "Mm-hmm." They said, "Okay, you don't know where I've been. This doesn't compare to okay."
Freddie made a full recovery, but he still questioned what he'd experienced.
For a while, I thought, well, I've got to do something. I've got to make something happen for the Lord. He sent me back for a purpose. I need to go make something happen. That wasn't it. For several months, I did that and prayed every morning, why? And so he took me to Jeremiah and showed me a verse there. And the verse simply says, "You will go to whom I send you to, and you will say what I have you to say." And I'm a simple person, but I understood that. And that's my purpose. I don't try to make things happen now. I wait for the day, and when He takes me to someone, and I say what He has me to say. And that makes it pretty simple.
Today, Freddie and his family savor their time together, though Freddie says he still anticipates returning to the place he calls home.
Heaven is real. It's a real place. He's a real person, and I look forward to the day that I will get to be there, but I'm not pushing it at this point. At first, when I came back, I was ready to go the next day, you know, but I love my family. I love my kids. I love my wife, and I'll stay as long as He allows me to stay. But when I do go, they don't have to worry about me. Dying is easy. Living is hard. There's someone out there that needs to know that heaven is a real place, God is a real person, and when you take that last breath, if you're a Christian, you're going to meet Him.